I'm Amelia, and this is my little sister, Talia.
Hello.
Today, we'll be learning about the giant hairy scorpion, one of the most misunderstood critters on Earth. And yes, she is holding one. If she isn't afraid of it, you shouldn't be either.
Hello everyone and welcome to Critter Ed TV, coming to you from the Tankoverde Therapeutic Zoo here in beautiful Tucson, Arizona. I'm your host, Jed Dodds, and I'm here with the co-creator of the therapeutic zoo model, Clint Elliott.
Hey folks, thanks for tuning in.
Now I know you guys came here to see Clint's two youngest daughters hold a scorpion with their bare hands, but this being our very first episode, we want to talk a little bit about the mission and the goal of Critter Ed TV. Our goal here is to provide critter enthusiasts of all ages with fun, truth-based videos of animals both wild and domesticated, and we're doing it for a great cause.
Yes, every penny generated by this channel goes to support the missions of the Therapeutic Zoo, which we'll learn more about later.
Yeah, so subscribe to Critter Ed TV, like and share this video and all future videos, and comment in the comment section below. These are things that you can do to help the mission and the goal of Critter Ed TV, and it costs you absolutely nothing.
Isn't there something about ringing a bell also?
Ringing a bell? Isn't that something you do when you hit your head?
Well, it is for our generation for sure, but you young folks probably know what to do.
All right, well, if you like what you see here, we even have more exciting ways to be able to contribute directly to the mission of Critter Ed TV. But Clint, I think right now it's time to go meet a very misunderstood scorpion.
Absolutely.
Let's do it.
Hi, Talia. Hi, Amelia.
Hey, Jed.
I can't believe it. You are holding a giant hairy scorpion with your bare hands.
Yep.
Well, aren't you afraid that it's going to sting you?
Why would we be scared?
Well, because it's a giant hairy scorpion, and it's giant and hairy, and like all scorpions, it has a stinger.
Yeah, but they're cool. They don't want to sting us.
Well, I thought that anytime you were close to a scorpion, they automatically want to sting you.
Not the giant hairy. It's the bark scorpion you might want to worry about.
So there's differences between scorpions. I think we really need to look into that to see what they are so we know what to look out for.
Definitely.
So Talia, what's one reason that a scorpion doesn't want to sting us?
Their venom is weak, so it's not useful for self-defense.
Yeah, some people believe that the giant hairy scorpion venom is no more potent than a bee sting, and it might actually even be less. So what's another reason that a scorpion doesn't want to sting us?
Well, their venom takes a ton of energy to produce, so it wouldn't make sense to sting someone as big as us because they might not have enough venom for their prey.
Wow, you guys know a lot about scorpions, and that's exactly right. It takes a lot of energy to produce that venom, and they want to save that for their prey, not really to be able to use on us. Now, these animals, the scorpions, get a pretty bad reputation, especially the giant hairy scorpion. Do you think that's justified?
No, definitely not.
But we've been told our whole lives that scorpions can kill us, so why should we believe any differently?
Maybe because no one in Arizona has died from a scorpion sting in decades, and no one has ever died from a giant hairy sting.
Wow, so perception is definitely different than reality. And that's with thousands of stings reported annually from one of the most venomously toxic scorpions in North America, which is the Arizona bark scorpion. By the way, that's gonna be the focus of our next episode. But right now, let's introduce our scorpion. Talia, who do you have?
Leonardo da Vinci.
I love the name Leonardo da Vinci. It gives a traditional scary animal this very disarming name. And that's gotta work out great for your therapeutic zoo outreach. Reach days. It must allow people to really take a step forward rather than a step back. Clint, you must have a high degree of confidence in your girls and being able to handle this scorpion.
I do, but I also think it's time for a little disclaimer when it comes to handling wild animals. I know we're talking about handling scorpions, and I'm allowing my daughters to handle this giant hairy scorpion, Leonardo da Vinci, like it's no big deal. But we do highly recommend that no member of the public handle wild animals without a tremendous amount of training and experience.
You're absolutely right, and there's always a risk that something could go wrong or something could happen. And if somebody is handling a wild animal, especially a scorpion, if they did get stung, they could have a serious medical condition if they were allergic to that venom, and that would be anaphylactic shock. So we definitely don't want anybody to go out there
there and handle scorpions. Right here, we have the proper training and the experience, and it's worth the risk to be able to handle Leonardo da Vinci in this way to really show a lot of why these animals are so misunderstood and really to be able to bring that into a great light. So we don't want anybody out there to go handle scorpions. And Clinton, saying that, there is a way in training your girls that you've done to be able to handle and transfer the scorpion from one person to the other. So why don't we show that?
Sure. The basic technique is a hand underhand technique. You never want to bring your hand over the top of a scorpion because you could accidentally bring it down on top of a critter like Leonardo. You don't want to do that. So what Amelia is going to do is she's going to put her hand underneath Talia's and give Leonardo a place to walk onto. Boom, nailed it. Safe transfer of the scorpion.
And I mean, it's so easy. Leonardo da Vinci didn't care one way or another. And we look very calm here. And I think that's another main part, is staying calm and really knowing your animal and how that animal is going to behave and how that animal is going to react.
Oh, scorpions and other wild animals can tell instantly if you're nervous, and they react differently if you're calm and you approach them with kindness and gentleness.
So now that Leonardo da Vinci is on Amelia's hands and we've got that transfer, girls, are you ready for some rapid fire questions about giant hairy scorpions?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, so what critter is most related to a giant hairy scorpion?
Spiders.
And why are they related to spiders?
They're both arachnids.
And what's unique about an arachnid?
They have 8 legs.
Ding, 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 you are a winner. Now, are they related to insects?
No.
Why not?
Because insects have 6 legs.
And what's another name that people would call an insect?
A bug.
Now, is a scorpion a bug?
Nope.
Then why do people think that they're a bug?
I have no idea.
I don't know either. Talia, how can you tell just by looking at the giant hairy scorpion that their venom is not a threat to humans?
Their size.
That's right. Size does matter. And in North America, the larger the scorpion, the less potent the venom is. But what if we had a baby giant hairy scorpion next to an adult Arizona bark scorpion? Could you tell the difference then?
Yeah, it's easy.
Well, how do you do it?
Well, wouldn't it be better if we showed people in the next episode where we brought out the Arizona bark scorpion?
Yeah, that would be way better.
Yeah, definitely. Now, Amelia, Tankaverde Therapeutic Zoo has a catchphrase that I absolutely love. What is it?
Tankaverde Therapeutic Zoo, where fear becomes wonder and wonder becomes passion.
I love it, and it works on so many levels, because when we can tell the truth about an animal, it can decrease the fear that people have on it. And if we can decrease that fear, well, we increase the passion. So for all you guys out there, we want to make sure that you subscribe to Critter Ed TV, like and share this episode, because we all need a little less fear and more passion in our lives.
Yeah, thank you everybody for watching.
What do you guys think? Do you guys have fun?
Yeah!
All right, well, that's good to do it for this episode. Catch us next time on Critter Ed TV, where fear becomes wonder and wonder becomes passion.
Bye. Bye.